Hello friends, in today's video we'll discuss objects in R language. In previous video we already discussed vector object. Now in this video we discuss about list, factors and matrix. Now we'll see the example of this objects in using in R studio. So we are creating list of three variables, say variable A, variable B, variable C, and three as one element. So first of all we need to create these A, B, C variables with the help of C function. We are creating these three variables, then we are creating list with the help of list function and storing that value of list in variable x. So list function is list of A, B, C and 3. So it creates the list with name x. To display the value of list, it will show after print of x, that is first value of A, first second element of the list, third element of the list, fourth element of the list. When we want to see specific element from the list, we can write it in this format, that is x of 1. X of 1 will display the first element of the list, that is value of A, it is 2, 3, 5. If we want to display second element of the list, we can write it as x of 2. So it displays the value of variable B, which is the second element of the list, and its value is AABBCCDD and E. If we want to display the second vector element from the list without its index, we can write it with the two square brackets, that x of first square bracket, second square bracket, 2, and then closing of both the square brackets. So it is like this, that is AABBCC, which is the second atom. If we want to display second and fourth vector element from the list, we can write it x of C of 2 and 4. So after executing this, it will show second vector's value, that is AABBCC, and third vector value is nothing but 3. Now to retrieve the vector data from the list and assign names to the vector. How to do this? It is assigned with the help of names. So our vectors, that is A, B, C and fourth element, that is 3, if we want to store it with vector 1, vector 2, vector 3 and 4 and with the names x, it is shown like this. After executing this get assigned. When we print the value of x, it will show that instead of element, it is showing vector 1, vector VC 2, 3 and 4. If we want to see particular value from vector 3, we can write x of vector 3. So it will show the value of vector 3. Same thing, we can write it x of dollar vector 3. It will show us the same result. If we want to only list get updated, not original object, so in that case we can write it that x of vector 2 of 2, means AABB B gets replaced with R program, which is shown here. When we print that B doesn't have any effect because that is the original object, but now that R program value gets updated in X, that is the list name. So we are getting that vector 2 instead of BB, R program gets replaced. And if we want to check it with particular vector only, then also we can see that vector 2 value gets updated, not B variables value get updated. Now we will see about the factor. Factor is a categorical value In vector, all value are of same type. So in factor, we are assigning male, female, 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 male, female, s, no, these different values. So assigning this with the help of factor function, then printing F1, it will show us whatever values we have assigned to it, and it is showing the levels that the particular data set having female, male, no and s, three categorical values are there. To display the level by user, we are using the factor function. If we want to know level count, we can use n levels of F1 function. So here levels are 4, that's why it is showing us 4, that is female, male, s, no. Okay, if we want to name the levels, then we can write it like levels of F1, that is levels names are nothing but female, male, no, s. Every count of level we can show it with the help of table function, that in the given values there are 4 female, 2 male, 2 no, 2 s. Then we'll see about matrix. About matrix, we all know matrix is of similar data type. Matrix contains similar type of data. We can create the matrix in this way also. Then dimension, right now it is null. We are creating 2 rows and 5 columns, and it is showing in this way. So matrix, in R language, matrix function is available with the help of which we can first of all give the input of values, number of rows, number of columns by this matrix function. Then matrix, to print the matrix, to transpose the matrix, we can use T functions. To extract the data, means dimension names, we can write it like this. Then matrix M1, we can display it like this. And to display the second row and third columns value particular, we can write it as a M1 of 2, 3. It shows us second row, third column value, that is nothing but 8. If we want to show only the value of second column, then we can write it M1 square bracket space (2). If we want to know value of second rows only, then we can write 2, space square bracket complete. It will show us the second row value. That's all in today's video about factors and matrix. Thank you for watching this video.